Alzheimer's is a progressive disease where the disease destroys nerve connections in the brain, making it progressively more difficult to do ordinary things. This disease might skip a generation, affect people on both sides of the family, appear seemingly from nowhere, or not be passed on at all.
Your husband's passing, what would you say is one of your fondest memories of him or with him?
With him is when we first met in high school, Monroe High School, and when we used to go back and forth to Florida for snowbirds, and when we had our children, because he loved his babies, you know. So, go on, next question.
What did you think of the disease before experiencing it firsthand? Were you aware of, I mean, obviously you were aware of the disease, but were you aware that it was hereditary? That
I didn't know it was hereditary, yeah. And his mother had it really bad, where she wouldn't even talk, she just stared. And we had to feed her, you know. But I did not know it was hereditary.
So in the 10 years that you had to deal with this, what was it like having to take care of him day in and day out?
Every day was different. And he did funny little things that I laughed afterwards, but not when they were happening.
Right.
You know, he'd hide my slippers in the medicine cabinet. Just different little things that he would do, you know, like pee in the trash barrel, poop in the trash barrel,
right.
Just different little.
Not funny when it happened, but definitely.
And play with his toys.
A little funny after, yeah.
Play with his little toys that he liked.
So from experiencing the disease firsthand, what have you actually learned about the disease? Like, now you know that it's hereditary.
Yeah. What have I learned about the disease? It's a devastating disease. It's, I think it's worse than cancer. Because with cancer, the doctor will tell you, you've only got a certain length of time to live. With Alzheimer's, they can't tell you how long you're going to live.
Right.
And I think it's between 8 and 10 years that they survive. Some have lasted longer.
So after your experiences and Grandpa passing, what is it now that you would like to do to help others?
Not that I can help somebody. I can tell them what I went through so they can be prepared. But you're never prepared for what they're going to do because every day is different.
So, and, I mean,
yeah.
With you going through this too, you know, you can be that supportive role for somebody, you know, who is also dealing with that.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
I was 5 years old, and my dad decided he was going to take us fishing. So he took us fishing one of the parks. And as we're fishing, a DEC officer walks up and asks him for his license, and he gave him his driver's license and not a fishing license.
I have a lot of fond memories of how much volunteering that my grandfather wanted me to do with him. So we volunteered at the senior living home, pushing the elderly and the mentally disabled down to church services, to also delivering flowers around Christmas time. And then...
But then I could carry it away now.
Also...
Because she likes to talk.
Also, I would have to say, it wasn't really a volunteering opportunity, but there was a little old lady, Mary Gazetta, that he always used to take care of until she died. And she was like family by the end, honestly. Those were my fondest.
When I was little and he worked at Delco, he used to bring me home a candy bar every morning in his pocket. I used to run downstairs and Skylark bar. And all the dresses he bought me. And
probably this was last year, when I had my Xbox, I'd take over there when I'd have to watch him. I would have my either a racing game or a wrestling game. No matter what game I'm playing, he'll always be interested. Especially if there's like loud, no, not loud, but like a loud, like interesting noise that gets his attention. Like if I'm driving and in my driving game, my car goes, shoots up the ramp, he'll be like, whoa. If I'm driving fast, he'll be like, wow, fast. Or if I'm playing any fighting game like wrestling or GTA and there's a female in there, he'll be like, ooh. Then he'll go like this, and he'll go like this. Yeah, that was funny.
Just so everybody knows, there's a black dick sitting right here. They put it there. I had nothing to do with it. I think, to be honest, my father-in-law, he really meant the world to me. And he saved me at a time when I needed to be saved. He was, to me, a parent. Oh, he was my father-in-law. But he was probably the most generous, caring person I've ever known. And for that, he's taught me much, but I will be forever eternally grateful, for I have known such a man.
On average, a person with this disease can live 4 to 8 years after diagnosis, but can live as long as 20 years depending on other factors. In this case with my grandfather, he lived 10 years after being diagnosed with Alzheimer's.